Good afternoon. So, ships are being invigorated. I've done it this way around to show you where the new ships that are available are for me. And as you can see, Cassie's Ewing, Cashew, gotta be a nut for this one, ain't ya? Is activatable. Yeah, it really is a what do you do thing. Anyway, let's activate. I broke the 3 million. Yay. This is gonna take me under my 100 million that I had got to. Oh, sorry, I didn't show you the stats, but you're gonna see how much they increase here. And just do the simple maths to extract it if you want. Yeah, okay. Maybe that's not quite true. Right, so lots to do here. Let's start here. Deal special damage to target enemy and call target ally to assist. Both attackers have an additional 10% critical damage. I'm not doing the Omega one, and those are holding off. They said ages ago that we were going to get them in daily rewards. We've yet to do that, so they're holding off until, and then I'll pick and choose which ones get what. So now it's deal special damage to target enemy and call a target ally to assist. Both attackers have an additional 20% critical damage. Guerrilla strike. Infiltration tactics. Okay. Dispel all debuffs on target ally and grant them stealth for one turn. If that ally is a rebel, also grant them. So stealth them for two turns, and if that ally is a rebel, also grant them 20% turn meter. And cooldown is from 4 to 3, cooldown of one on the Omega. And threat assessment. Inflict target lock and tenacity down for. I don't think this changes for 2 turns on target enemy. These effects can't be resisted. If the target enemy has any buffs, remove 20%, is it? Oh, 18%. Remove. Oh, I see. The Omega is takes it to 20%. So we're there. Cool. What else does this ship do? We've got these two here to do as well. All allies have 17% critical avoidance and 5% evasion. Oh, these numbers are going to change, aren't they? All allies have a percentage critical avoidance and a percentage evasion when attacked by target locked enemies. These bonuses are doubled for rebel allies. Oh, thank you, Rib. It's really racking up the old GP as well, isn't it? So all allies have 25% critical avoidance and 6% evasion when attacked by target locked enemies. These bonuses are doubled for rebel allies. And Trailblazer, deal physical damage to target enemy. Target lock Cassian's Ewing gains a percentage turn meter. Turn meter. So, that is the ship done there. Let's see whether we can get a fleet battle going. I believe your payout is after mine. If you watched earlier, you would have seen part of my fifth in ships. I've also unlocked Millennium Falcon. So Millennium Falcon steps back, and hopefully this one, yeah, it must be, I can see the stars, is the Cassian U-wing, or Cashew wing. Cass U-wing, yeah, Cashew wing. Okay, so I read all the abilities. Whether I actually remember what they are and do will be something completely different. Who am I bringing in? I think I'm going to bring in Boba. It's a Gear 12 Boba, actually. Right, so what have we got here? Inflict target lock and tenacity down for 2 turns on target enemy. These effects can't be resisted. Gonna hide? I don't think you will hide, which is why I targeted you from the outset. Oh dear, I'm getting torn a new one here. See if we can do some mobility blocking. Nope, but we can get rid of a tie. What's this one do? Deal special damage to target enemy and call a target ally to assist. Both attackers have an additional 20% critical damage. Him. Oh, maybe I'm not. Yeah, I did. What's this one do? Dispel all debuffs on target ally. Grant them stealth for 2 turns. Can I do that on myself? Yes, I can. I didn't dispel target lock there. This could be close. Hopefully, I've got, yeah. Two debuts, two wins. Wow. I need to do the lottery today. watching.